This is Mickey Gilley, this is real life, and this is real music.
Real life, real music radio, with your host, Kyle Hutton.
Thank you very much.
When the train pulled into the station, rolled up his sleeves, rosin up his bow, little upside down, orange blossom special. If you want to make a living, you got to put on a good show. When he smelled the smoke and the cinders, slick back his hair, open up his case, play Cherokee Fiddle, played it for the whiskey. Good whiskey never let him lose his place. He was always there, playing for the miners. Devil's Dream was a song they understood. Then he'd go back to Oklahoma and wait till the train was running and the weather was good. When he smelled the smoke and the cinders, slick back his hair, open up his case, play Cherokee Fiddle, played it for the whiskey. Good whiskey never let him lose his place.
The right hand is on the fiddle.
Dressing up like cowboys, and the cowboys putting feathers and turquoise on, and the music is sold by lawyers. I'm a lawyer, man. Fools who fiddled in the middle of the station are gone. Some folks say they ain't never gonna miss him. Old fiddles squeal like the engine brakes. Cherokee Fiddle, he's gone forever. Like the music of the whistle the old locomotive made. So when you smell smoke and the cinders, stick back your hair, open up your case, play Cherokee Fiddle, play it for the whiskey. Good whiskey never lets you lose your place. No, good whiskey never lets you lose your place.
Sing it on. Oh, no, no.
Ladies and gentlemen, much. Mr. Johnny Lee right here tonight.
Thank you.
Johnny, I'm so honored for you to be here with us tonight. And you know, a lot of the times I sit up here and I talk too much. I don't want to do that tonight because I want to hear you guys sing. But I wanted to ask you if you would possibly sing one of the songs my wife and I used to dance to at the old dance halls in College Station when we were going to school there. little song that you did called One in a Million. I wonder if you'd play that song for us.
Sure. Thank you. Be glad to. Sometimes it seems the world is a jumble. Through it all I was born to stumble, searching for something love to find. Take your love in bits and pieces, coming to you only when it eases that lonely feeling. Oh, it gets in my mind when you treat me so kind, and those hard times come a dime a dozen. Girls with your kind of loving, one in a million, so hard to find. Hard times come a dime a dozen. Girls with your kind of loving, one in a million, I'm lucky you're mine. I know your friends don't think much of me. They say you're a fool to love me, but girl, I know they'll never turn you around. You're bound to love your hard luck poet. If I let you down, you don't show it. You know it don't matter. They can't touch what we found. When the sun goes down and those hard times come a dime a dozen. Girls with your kind of loving, one in a million, so hard to find. Hard times come a dime a dozen. Girls with your kind of loving, one in a million, I'm lucky you're mine. Hard times come a dime a dozen. Girls with your kind of loving, one in a million, they're so hard to find. Hard times come a dime a dozen. Girls with your kind of loving, one in a million, I'm lucky you're mine. Just a minute. I wonder if he's still dancing with her. Are you still dancing with her?
I am dancing with her, but here's the problem. We dance so close that we got five kids and she's at home taking care of them now.
You're up here laughing about it.
Well, yes, sir. And you've given us some great music to dance to over the years. And thank you for being here and sharing it with us tonight. We appreciate you.
Picking Up Strangers.
I did another song in the movies with Diane Keaton and Robert Blake. Picking up strangers, let me tell you about the danger. If you don't like taking chances, then better keep moving on, my friend. Picking up strangers, let me tell you about the danger. Some are just common thieves, they say. Next thing you know, one will steal your heart away. Sometimes this old life seems like a highway, just keeps rolling on and on that highway. Meet a lot of strangers, pass a lot of danger on your way home. Picking up strangers, let me tell you about the danger. If you don't like taking chances, then better keep moving on, my friend. Picking up strangers, let me tell you about the danger. Some are just common things they say. Next thing you know, one steal your heart away. Sometimes this old life seems like a highway, just keeps rolling on and on that highway. Meet a lot of strangers, pass a lot of danger on your way home. Picking up strangers, let me tell you about the danger. If you don't like taking chances, then better keep moving on, my friend. Picking up strangers, let me tell you about the danger. Some are just common things they say. Next thing you know, one stay hard. Oh, shucks. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Over 17 big old country music hits. That's a long way from Texas City, Altaloma, Texas. Where you got your start. One of the things, I don't know if everybody knows this about Johnny or not, but first off, he started playing music in high school. Your rock and roll band, Johnny Lee and the Roadrunners, was one of the first things that got going.
Yeah, that's right.
And from there, I want to thank you for one of the things you did next, and that was for the stint of duty that you did in the United States Navy on the USS Chicago.
Well, I tell you what, I'm proud to serve, but here's the story behind it. I went to join the Marines. The guy was going to lunch. The Navy guy was sitting across the hall, had all this gold crap on him, on his sleeves and on his chest, you know. I don't know how long it took to get all that stuff. I don't know how long it took him to give me a ticket. This boot camp, about 15 minutes. But I didn't even know Vietnam was going on at the time. I just lost my high school sweetheart, we broke up. Lost my band, broke up. So I did the only thing that was left for a boy to do, join the military.
Join the military. Well, thank you for your service. We appreciate that. We appreciate that. Then, man, 10 years with Mickey Gilley playing in the clubs and out on tour. You know, one of the early things that I remember about your music was the theme song on a television program called The Yellow Rose of Texas. And that's one of my favorite songs of yours, and it looks like that you've got some good firepower to sing that song with you tonight, maybe. Yeah, I'm looking at you. I'm looking at you over there. I wonder if y'all play that one for us tonight for old time's sake.
You bet.
Thank you.
That's good. Originally did a song with Lane Brody.
I'm going to do a Georgian holiday. I'm going to do a Georgian holiday. There's a yellow rose in Texas I'm going home to see. Though other men have held her, her heart belongs to me.
You traveled down some dusted roads, slept out in the rain, but this yellow rose is always here when you come home again.
She knows I've done some hard times.
You stumbled and you fell. I just kept your pride from dying.
You saved my soul from hell.
She's a diamond of the desert.
She's a golden flower of spring.
She's a yellow rose of Texas. She can make a man a king.
There's a yellow rose in Texas. She knows the dues I paid. I'm going home to tell her I wish I'd never strayed.
You couldn't see beyond yourself, your pain and wounded pride. But now you know the truth is in the way you feel inside.
She knows I've done some hard times.
You stumbled and you fell. Just kept your pride from dying.
You saved my soul from hell.
Yes,
she's a diamond of the desert.
She's a golden flower of spring.
She's a yellow rose of Texas.
She can make a man a king.
Yes, a yellow rose of Texas can make a man a king. Georgian holiday, folks.
Johnny Lee!
Yeah. So, very beautiful. Beautiful job.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, you're very welcome.
It's hard not to be great when you're standing and singing next to Johnny Lee.
Man, I know that's right. I feel better already sitting right here. So, 1984 was a big year because that's the year that song came out. But also, one of my other favorite Johnny Lee songs came out that year, a song called You Could Have Heard a Heartbreak. I bet these guys know that one.
I bet, yeah.
Well, let's do it.
Don't just tell them about no boy that went out. They were supposed to be going out. He got caught. Probably never had anybody in here. Behind the bar, I see some crazy things. I watch those disappearing wedding rings. Telephone call, paging so-and-so. There he is, shaking his head no. He's got this girl hanging all over him. He can't quit now, he's gone out on a limb. The place turned quiet as a mummy's tomb. Guess who happened? You walk in the room. Could have heard a heartbreak. You could have heard a teardrop. I feel so bad for her sake. What's she gonna do? Chances that a fool takes, never knowing when to stop. You could have heard a heartbreak breaking right in two. Walks on over with tears in her eyes. She's gonna hear a pack of lies. Silence is deafening, all eyes are on her. What will she say to that innocent girl? Hands start shaking, the words don't come. She's in shock, her whole body is numb. Everyone there, holding their breath. Slightest whisper, know what she said. Could have heard a heartbreak.
Chances that a fool takes, never knowing when to stop. You could have heard a heartbreak breaking right in two. Could have heard a heartbreak. You could have heard a teardrop. I feel so bad for her, saying, what's she gonna do? Chances that a fool takes, never knowing when to stop. You could have heard a heartbreak breaking right in two. Could have heard a heartbreak.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So far, you know, we've been revisiting some of our favorite hits. Are y'all doing okay out there already? Y'all having a good time? Okay. So one of the things I love, Johnny, is that not only are you still out playing shows and playing all the songs that we love, but you're still putting out music. And in 2016, you put out a song called Never Been to Texas. Yeah, and I know that's not true because you are like almost the epitome of what Texas means. But never been to Texas, still putting out great music. I wonder if we could get a song off the newest record.
Well, that's not the newest record, but yeah.
Well, what's the newest one?
Well, the newest one's called Everything's Gonna Be All Right.
Okay. All right. All right.
But I'd like to sing the song for you.
Please do.
Never been to Texas.
I love it.
You got it, man. So a man on the TV is out in California talking about where we all came from. You know the reason we're all here? Fairly accidental. Said it's all because of evolution. Took a drink of coffee, walked out of my front porch, looked up at heaven, and looked at my horse, and I thought, man, he ain't never seen a sunset out west, cactus or paintbrush blooming springtime. You ain't never heard a coyote crying, young colt take off and running for the first time. Well, I thought a lot about it, sometimes we overthink it, but the only thing that makes any sense is, if you don't believe in God, you ain't never been to Texas. All those two people across the Red River. Lord, it would surely open up their eyes. When I wake up every morning, I look out at heaven. It ain't hard to realize. If there's anybody out there still trying to figure it out about where we all come from, what life's all about, I'd like to tell you. You ain't never seen a sunset out west, cactus or paintbrush blooming springtime. You ain't never heard a coyote crying, young colt take off and running for the first time. Well, I thought a lot about it, sometimes they overthink it, but the only thing that makes any sense is, if you don't believe in God, you ain't never been to Texas. No, no, if you don't believe in God, you ain't never been to Texas. Woo. very much. Appreciate it.
That water's for you.
Toast time.
Time for a toast. You got yours? He's got a big old Dr. Pepper back there. Everybody else? Everybody got something? How about to great country music from Johnny Lee at Do-Si-Do tonight? Can we cheers? Cheers to that? Cheers. Cheers for that. So, you know, I don't think we can be in an old barn somewhere in Texas and skip over the song "Hey Bartender." I mean, that seems like that might be appropriate if we could hear that one.
No, record company wasn't going to release it on me because it had a saxophone on it. Yeah, and I said, "Look, this is toward the end of my career. If I'm gonna hang myself, let me be the one to kick the horse." So, well, it was one of the first videos ever done. Okay. That and the Yellow Rose. "Hey Bartender."
Well, it's a good song, and I think we got one in here tonight.
Bartender?
So y'all take care of them. Take care of your waitresses and bartenders tonight. Y'all give it up, Mr. Johnny Lee.
Went partying the other night, started drinking, it got real tight. We were playing with all my friends. Felt so good, man, we played again. Hey bartender,
hey bartender,
hey bartender,
hey bartender.
Go 1, 2, 3 more glasses of beer. She was sitting way down at the end. Hey baby, can we be friends? You look as sweet as can be. Come on up here and drink a beer. Hey bartender,
hey bartender,
hey bartender,
hey bartender.
Go 1, 2. 3 more glasses of beer. No one calls no saxophone. Johnny Hill's gonna slide the guitar. Jeremiah's on the guitar. Robert Harris on the harp. On piano. Temperatures on bass. You have to give a drummer some. Give a drummer some. Put a load on drums. Every cowboy band, bro. Good We was having so much fun, didn't know it was half past one. Turned around, gonna have one more. Looked at the clock, it was half past four. Hey, bartender.
Hey, bartender.
Hey, bartender.
Hey, bartender.
Draw one, two, three more glasses of beer. With the jukebox playing everything, everybody was beginning to sing. That's when I heard somebody call. Hey, bartender.
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 Draw one, two, three more glasses of beer. Bum, 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 bum.
Thank you.
They just told me that drink sales went up by 300% during that song right over there. That's amazing how that works. Well, let's go to that record, that brand new, the most recent record, Everything's Gonna Be All Right. I wonder if y'all play that one for us tonight.
Sure. before we get through, before I do Looking for Love, I'm gonna do this song, Everything's Gonna Be All Right, but my daughter wrote a song on the album. Ask me about that in a minute, and I'll tell you about it.
I would love to hear about it.
It's all or nothing, it's all on you. You wanna win, but sometimes you lose. Do your best and hold your head up high. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Brand new day brings a brand new light. Everything's gonna be all right. Turn on the news and it's bad again. Makes you wonder if it ever ends. Love's floating somewhere deep and wide. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Brand new day brings a brand new light. Everything's gonna be all right. Little boy in a hospital bed. Mom and daddy ain't giving up yet. They say a prayer and a voice from inside says everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Brand new day brings a brand new light. Everything's gonna be all right. Streets are empty and the buildings are bare. Troubled hearts beating everywhere. Hold on to each other, hold on tight. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Brand new day brings brand new life. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything is gonna be all right.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
What a beautiful song. Man, what a song we need, you know, at a time like this too. Okay. Tell me about the song that your daughter...
Well, every time I get ticked off my daughter, I listen to the song. I can't be mad at her anymore. She wrote a song about me. She called me up on the phone, asked me a bunch of questions, you know, about my childhood and things she never asked me before. So I answered her, and next thing you know, she wrote the song, sent it to me. So I felt obliged to put it on my new record. And back next, in the middle of August, I want to go to Nashville. They're going to do a video on her.
Oh, wow.
And she's going to release this song as a single.
Awesome.
But,
awesome.
But I'd like to get Georgina to sing this song for you.
Perfect.
She does a great job. It's called I Was Born to Be My Father's Daughter.
He was one of six on a dairy farm. Never knew his daddy, so that must have been hard. Shipped out at 18. You gotta fight for what you believe in. Well, he was born to hit the road with that big old Texas soul. His heart is fast and wild, blue bonnets in the field. But that man's just like an old mule. His will is made of steel. My blood runs just like his does. Whiskey with a splash of holy water. I was born to be my father's daughter. He says the grass ain't greener on the other side. Bloom way up cause you're one of a kind. Sing songs, play bars. His fame don't come by wishing on a star. He's a shoulder I can cry on. He shows me how to be strong. His heart is vast and wide. Blue bonnets in a field. That man's just like an old mule. His will is made of steel. My blood runs just like his does. Whiskey with a splash of holy water. I was born to be my father's daughter. Roots run deep, rivers run free. If you know him, you know me. His heart is fast and wide, blue bonnets in a field. Well, that man's just like an old mule. His will is made of steel. My blood runs just like his does. Whiskey with a splash of holy water. I was born to be my father's daughter. To be my father's daughter. I'm my father's daughter.
Wow. What a gift that song is. Goodness gracious. Have you guys enjoyed the show so far tonight? Man. Johnny, I can't tell you, as a kid that grew up the first half of my life down in Friendswood, Texas, my dad worked over in Pasadena just off Spencer Highway. I mean, I grew up a fan listening to you and Mickey Gilley, and thank you guys so much for being here tonight. It's such an honor for us.
Thank you.
Well, I know there's another song that's a lot of people's favorite song that you can't get out of here before you play. So I'm going to turn the stage over to you. Y'all give it up one more time for Mr. Johnny Lee.
Thank you. Good. I'm still looking for love, too. I spent a lifetime looking for you. Single bars and good time lovers were never true. Playing a fool's game, hoping to win.
telling those sweet lies, losing again. I was looking for love in all the wrong places, looking for love, too many faces, searching their eyes, looking for traces of what I'm dreaming of, hoping to find a friend and a lover. I bless the day I discover another heart, looking for love. I was alone then, no love in sight. I did everything I could to get me through the night, almost. Don't know where it started or where it might end. Turned to a stranger, just like a friend. I was looking for love in all the wrong places, looking for love. Too many faces searching their eyes, looking for traces of what I'm dreaming of, hoping to find a friend and a lover. I'm blessed the day I discover another heart, looking for love. You came a knocking at my heart's door. Everything I've been looking for. There's no more looking for love in all the wrong places, in too many faces, searching their eyes, looking for traces of what I'm dreaming of. Now that I found a friend and a lover, God bless the day I discovered you. Oh, you looking for love. Thank you, folks. Appreciate it. I had a good time. Thank you all very much. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Johnny Lee. Y'all give it up for this band up here tonight. Oh, yeah. And the show continues, folks. Here we go.
If I sent a rose to you for every time you made me blue, you'd have a room full of roses. And if I sent a rose of white for every time that I cried all night, you'd have a room full of roses. And if I took the petals and would tear them all apart, I'd be tearing up the roses just the way you broke my heart. But if someday you're feeling blue and you could say a rose, maybe two, don't send me a room full of roses. All I want is my arms around you. Mr. Lee Henry's on the keyboard. look so easy. Just like the record. And if I took the petals, I would tear them all apart. I'd be tearing up the roses, just the way you broke my heart. And if someday you're feeling blue, and you could send a rose, maybe two, don't send me a room full of roses. All I want is my arms around you. Yay! Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Kyle.
How you doing?
I'm doing great. That's the song that brought me to the dance.
That did bring you to the dance. Well, welcome to Real Life Real Music here at Do-Si-Do in the Woodlands. It's an honor to have you this evening.
Well, thank you.
Huge honor. Now tell me.
At my age, it's a pleasure to be here.
Well, at my age, it's a pleasure to be here with you. So I want to ask you, that last song that you just sang for us, that was an accidental hit for you,
absolutely,
wasn't it? Tell us a little bit about that
absolutely
song.
Absolutely. I went to the recording studio to record a song called She Called Me Baby All Night Long. Because the lady that had the jukebox in Gilley's, she asked me, she heard me do it on the TV show, and she asked me, she says, that's my favorite song, She Called Me Baby All Night Long, and I'd like for you to record that for me. I said, ma'am, I haven't made a record in quite a few years now, you know. She says, just make that one recording for me, it'd be good for you here at the club. That's when I was doing a little local TV show in Houston. And I went in the studio to record She Called Me Baby All Night Long, and for the flip side, I turned to the band, and they said, we need a song for the flip. And I said, let's do the old song, Room Full of Roses. And they said, we never played that one before. So I played it up for them on the piano. They wrote a little chart on it. They said, it's easy enough. Started into the song, got about 25, 30 seconds into it. I stopped and the band said, what'd you quit for? And I said, it's gonna sound to me, it's like my cousin, Jerry Lee Lewis. And the bass guitar player said, who cares? It's gonna be the B-side, nobody's ever gonna hear it. I said, you got a point. So I went ahead and recorded it. I was very relaxed, and the song turned out to be my first number one single nationally.
That's crazy. That's crazy.
Thank you, ladies.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies. Hey, it didn't take me long to figure out the ladies like flower songs, too.
They do, and you didn't stop there either.
No.
You didn't stop there at all.
I recorded every flower song I could find after that.
Well, play us another one of those.
I recorded Room Full of Roses, Overlooked An Orchid While Searching for a Rose, Big Bouquet of Roses, San Antonio Rose. The only one I missed was Tiptoe Through the Tulips. You want to hear the second one?
Yeah, please, let's do it.
The orchid is a flower that blooms so tenderly to thrill the fairest lady of the land. It placed beside a blushing rose, a rose could not compare. But how was such as I to understand? I overlooked an orchid while searching for a rose. The orchid that I overlooked was you. The rose that I was searching for has proved to be untrue. The orchid that I found, my dear, was you. Yes, it was. The orchid that I found, my dear, was you. See if you remember this one. George Jones wrote it and I sang it. You made it number one for me. I've been living a new way, a love that I love so. I can see the clouds are gathering, and the storm will wreck our home. Well, last night he held you tightly, and you didn't even show. This is true, I was watching,
watching you
from the window up above. You must have thought that I was sleeping. I wish that I had been. It's best to get to know you and the way your heart can sin. 'Cause I thought we belonged together, and our hearts fit like a glove. I was wrong, 'cause I was watching,
watching
from the window up above. I lost my love while I was watching,
watching
from the window up above. Remember this song by Ray Price. It was number one for Ray. You made it number one for MG. A bright array of city lights, as far as I can see. The great white way shines through the night for lonely guys like me. The cabarets and the honky tonks and flashing signs invite a broken heart to lose itself in the glow of city lights. Lights that say forget her name in a glass of sherry wine. Lights that offer other girls for empty hearts like mine. They paint a pretty picture, but my arms can't hold them tight, and I just can't say I love you to a street of city light. I just can't say I love you to a street of city light. Yeah! Thank you. Thanks for making those songs number one for me in the country charts. You know, after Room Full of Roses, I had three more that followed with number one.
We could do just, if I got my count right, you've got 17 number ones. You could just do a whole set of number ones and sing to us for, you know, 2 hours. That's the amazing thing. And I got to tell Johnny a few minutes ago, you know, I grew up down in Friendswood, Texas. My dad worked over in Pasadena. Every pickup truck that is in our neighborhood had a kick bumper sticker and a Gilley's bumper sticker on it. And I knew as soon as I was old enough to see over the bar where I wanted to go, and that was to Gilley's in Pasadena, so I could come hear you sing.
Hey, I'm trying to keep that logo out there for the folks, you know. Keep that brand name out there for the folks to know that I'm still around. At 85, I'm still doing pretty good.
I'd say you're doing really good. So I want to ask you, I'm interested, you know, I've had the opportunity to talk to a lot of artists up here, and one of the things that always amazes me is somebody's ability to pick a great song, and you've recorded so many great songs. You just sang a bunch of them in that medley. Bill Anderson, George Jones, you've picked so many great songs. I want to ask you about one by Sam Cooke, Bring It On Home, that you recorded. What made you pick that one?
Well, I always loved the song, and I've always loved a variety of music. And when I started in the music industry, I wasn't looking to be a country music singer. I was looking to be a performer in music, no matter whether it was country, rock, soul, blues, or whatever, you know. I like all kinds of music. And so I tried to follow my cousin, Gilley, listening to the music industry, like I said before. And when I found the song that I used to do, Bring It On Home, I presented it to the guy that was producing records for me there in Nashville, and I said, this is a great song, and I'd like to play it for you. Sent it to piano, and I ran through it for him a couple of times, and I said, I think we needed to do it, and do it like this, and do an arpeggio, you know, and to do a key change in it. And it turned out to be, I think, in the 70s, probably the best record that I made in the 70s, and I still think so today. After I listened to it played, don't think I could go back and repeat it any better than what I did back then.
Well, it's a great, amazing version.
Can we do it for you?
I would love to hear all that right, tonight. Let's go. Is that okay with you guys?
If you ever change your mind about leaving me behind, oh, bring it to me, bring your sweet loving, bring it on home to me. I know I laughed when you left. Now I know only hurt myself. Oh, bring it to me. Bring your sweet loving. Bring it on home to me. Yeah.
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 Bradley. I'll give you jewelry and money too. That ain't all, honey, that ain't all I'm gonna do for you. Oh, bring it to me. Bring your sweet loving. Bring it on home to me. You know I tried to treat you right, but you stayed out, you stayed out late at night. But I bring your sweet loving, bring it on home to me. Yeah,
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 yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's always been one of my favorite songs also. You get into that tune pretty good.
What a great song and a great version of that. Okay, so I got to tell you. Do what? Sing it again. They want to hear that one again.
Yeah.
Hold on. There's.
Got all those yes at the end of it. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm going to tell you this, and you guys will appreciate this with me. The problem is there are some acts like Mickey Gilley and Johnny Lee that it would take two or three concerts to hear all of their hits. So while I would love to hear that one again, I'm going to ask him about another one. Because here's the deal. I was curious. You got to imagine I was we'll call it a formative preteen kid when I lived down in the Friendswood, Texas area. And, at Gilley's, I heard that the girls all got prettier at closing time. But your guys at the door were doing their job and wouldn't let me in, so I didn't get to figure it out for myself.
That's such a true story. When the guy brought the song in and I listened to it, I said, I love the song. I don't think I can do the tune justice. And I kept putting it off, and finally he told me, he says, send it to the piano, give me that boogie beat that you play on the piano. So I sent it to the piano, I went, and started playing that little riff, and he started singing, don't the girls, I said, hey, I like it. We recorded it on that particular day, and it has become the most played recording that I made because it's such a true story.
I can't tell if the girls in the audience love or hate that, Mickey. I tell you what, bring me a couple of drinks. I'm going to try it out.
The girls definitely get better looking at closing time, and I tell you what, I found out too later that the guys start looking pretty good to them, too. such a great, probably the song that, one tune that I have to perform in the show. At 85, I'm still doing the song. The girls all get pretty close in time. And I don't mind telling you that I still enjoy doing the song because it's such a true story. It's a song that everybody can relate to. And it's a fact. The opposite sex looks better at closing time. The more you drink, the better they look.
There you go.
You want me to do that for you?
I would. I'm laying it up for you there, Mick.
One, two, three, pick. Now the girls all get prettier at closing time. Now they all began to look like movie stars. Now the girls all get prettier in closing time. When the change starts taking place, you put the globe on every face of the fallen angel of the Backstreet Boys. If I could rate them on a scale from 1 to 10, looking for a 9, but 8 could work right in. A few more drinks and I might slip to 5 or even 4. But when tomorrow morning comes and I wake up with a number 1, well, never do it anymore. Now the girls all get prettier in closing time. Now they all begin to look like movie stars. Now the girls all get prettier in closing time. And when the change starts taking place, you put the globe on every face of the fallen angels of the Backstreet Boys. Are friendly. Johnny Hem, steel guitar. I don't mean to criticize the girls at all. I'm no Robert Redford, even Overhaul. We all picture in our minds a girl that looks just right. Ain't it funny? Ain't it strange? The way a man's opinions change when he starts to spend that lonely night. Now the girls all get prettier to close in time. Now they all begin to look like movie stars. Now the girls all get prettier to close in time. When the change starts taking place, put the globe on every face of the fallen angel of the Backstreet Boys. What I say? Fallen angels of the Backstreet Boys. I'm talking to you, mama. Yeah. I got something I want to say to you. I know a lot of the folks are probably wondering why I'm not sitting to the keyboard playing the piano. I had an accident in 2009. I lost my hands and able to play the keyboard. In fact, I'm having a hard time walking. I'm going for stem cell therapy tomorrow in California to try to get my back in shape. Whether my hands come back or not, I doubt it, but 85. But I had a pretty good career playing piano.
Yeah. Thanks to Lee.
When I found Lee over here, I was getting ready to retire. I said, this is not going to happen anymore. I found him. I said, I want to go out and do the recordings as close as I can to my records. And that's what he's been capable of playing the piano for me.
Well, he's doing a super job, super job.
Every time he gets on the bus, I say, how's my hands doing?
Well, I know I can tell you from everybody here, man, we're just glad you're here singing to us tonight. So thank you. Thank you for that.
The only thing the good Lord left me with my voice. My body went south on me. My legs are gone and my back is gone, but I'm still here.
Okay, y'all remember when I said earlier when I was introducing this show that y'all were going to be active participants in the show. So, Mickey, I need to see if you'll do something for me. I need a liner for the beginning of our radio program.
Absolutely.
So if you'll say, this is Mickey Gilley, and this is Real Life, Real Music.
Real Life, Real Music. Oh, yes.
Yeah, this is Mickey Gilley, and this is Real Life, Real Music. Then I need y'all to go nuts, okay, for about 4 minutes, and then I'm going to stop you. No. I'm just kidding. I'll give you the cut, but let's raise the roof.
This is Mickey Gilley. This is Real Life, and this is Real Music. Not bad.
That was good.
That's a pretty good one.
They did good. Okay, I want to ask you. You kind of glossed over something here in one of your earlier stories, and that was a little bit about your family tree, which is a very interesting family tree. Now,
absolutely.
You got You guys kind of covered all the bases as far as the cousins went. You had the rock and roll star playing the devil's music, right?
Well,
and then you got the country music star, and then you got the, then you got Jerry Falwell, right? Which is a whole nother end of the spectrum. Tell me, where does that come from? How does one family have that much passion and talent musically in it? Tell us a little about
that. Well, I was telling
you
a bit earlier, you know, I grew up in Fairdale, Louisiana, and of course my two famous cousins, Jerry Lee Lewis and Reverend Jimmy Swaggart. And we all three had success in the different kinds of music. The folks were kind enough in my country music field to give me 17 number one songs starting in 1974 when Roomful of Roses went national for me. And I followed it with 16 more number one songs. And of course my other cousin, Jerry Lewis, is in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland, Ohio. And of course, I patterned myself after my cousin, Jerry Lee, so many years, you know, doing his music, and that's what kept me working, I think. But my other cousin, Reverend Swaggart, outsold everybody in the world as far as gospel music is concerned. So we had three different kinds of music, gospel, rock and roll, and country. And I always said, if I wanted to make money, I should have followed my cousin, Reverend Swaggart. He made more money than me and Jerry Lee Lewis put together. Tax free.
I'm not even going to try to follow that with anything. I'm going to ask you about one of your other number ones that you had back in 1981 called You Don't Know Me.
Let me tell you about this song. This is a great song written by Cindy Walker, and I got to tell you that, of course, Eddie Arnold has his name on it too, you know. But the song, when the producer first brought it into the recording studio, I told him, I said, the best version of this song was by Ray Charles. He says, don't worry about it. This is going to be a good record for you, Gilley. And I'm thinking, I don't know about this, you know. I can't follow Ray Charles. He said, I'm going to put it in an album. So I'm thinking if he puts it in an album, not a problem, because I knew how many albums I was selling. So I recorded, not thinking anything about it. So I recorded You Don't Know Me. I'll get right here in a minute. I recorded You Don't Know Me, and the record company liked my version so well they released it as a single. And it scared me because I'm thinking, you know, I can't follow Ray Charles. But the record comes out and it starts climbing the charts and it makes it all the way to number one. And then I get the thrill of my life and my career. I get to sing it with Ray.
Come on.
Wow. Wow.
So that was a big plus for me. And usually in the shows, I show them a little clip of me and Ray doing the song. But I got a chance to do You Don't Know Me with Ray Charles. And that was a big thrill of me. But after you see him performing, I said, now you know why I didn't want to follow Ray Charles. But you want to do it?
Let's do it.
You give your hand to me, then you say hello, and I can hardly speak. My heart is beating so, and anyone can tell you think you know me well, but you don't know me. No, you don't know the one who dreams of you at night and longs to kiss your lips, wants to hold you tight. To you I'm just a friend, that's all I've ever been. You don't know me. I never knew the art of making love, though my heart it will run. Shy, I let my chance go by, a chance that you might love me too. You give your hand to me, and then you say goodbye. And I watch you walk away, sad that lucky guy. You'll never, never know the one who loves you so. You don't know me. You'll never, never, never know the one who loves you so. No, you don't know me. Thank you. Thank you for making number one for me in the country, George.
Yeah.
You got a song called Paradise and Apple on there?
I do.
Let me tell you a little bit about that song.
Please do.
I was playing Lake Tahoe with Johnny, and I get a call from the producer of Chips. They wanted us to come in and do a little cameo in a thing they were shooting at the Palomino Club in North Hollywood. And on the stage performing was a little lady named Charlie McLean. And I knew that she recorded for Epic Records. So I walked over to her when she came off the stage and I said, Charlie, how do you feel about doing duets? I got the idea from watching my friend Conway Twitty and Loretta Lynn. So how do you feel about doing duets? And she says, never thought about doing duets, but she would entertain the offer. So I didn't hear from her for 6 months. And I happened to be at the Hall of Shame, I mean fame. I was at the Hall of Fame Motor Inn in Nashville. And I get a call from Nora Wilson, her producer. They knew where to find me, see, I was at the bar. So they called me, that's four cell phones, folks. All right, this is in 1983. So he calls me they called me over to the payphone. I went to the payphone, and it was Nora Wilson, her producer, and he says, I understand you want to sing with Charlie McLean. I said, well, we talked about it, you know, when I was in North Hollywood with her, but I never heard from her. He says, I'm working with her on an album down here, won't you come down? We jumped in the car with a guy flying my airplane with me. We drive down, I walk in, and there, musicians are working on this song called Paradise Tonight. Producer says, how do you feel about making this song a duet? I said, I got no problem with it. I walk out in the studio, since we both recorded for Epic Records, no problem with contract or anything. About 90 minutes later, we have recorded Paradise Tonight. As I'm leaving the studio, I'm walking down the steps, and I turn to the guy flying my airplane with me, I said, that has got to be the biggest piece of junk I think I've ever recorded. 20-something weeks later, it's number one in the country charts.
Wow.
I turned to my guy flying my airplane with me. I said, you know what? That's a pretty good record, wasn't it? Now, if you want me to do that one, I got to get George Gene over here to help me.
Oh, please do.
You want to do this? It's my urbanette. And, well, you heard her do that song that Johnny's daughter wrote. George Gene. Duet, we had a couple other songs that was duets, but that was the only one that went number one for us, Paradise Tonight. one I didn't like.
Yeah, I like such it. Great song.
I like it.
Well, hey,
I like it. Thank you.
I was going to say, there's sometimes when it pays to be wrong.
I was wrong on a bunch of them. Right. I don't mind telling you. I was wrong on A Room Full of Roses. I was on Paradise Tonight. I was wrong. I was wrong on Stand By Me. I was wrong on Put Your Dreams Away, Talk to Me.
Now you're just bragging.
That's all that matters to me. I was wrong on a lot of the songs that the producer picked for me to do. And
man.
I owe a lot of the credit to Jim Ed Norman for picking the songs that brought me to the dance, so to speak.
Well, you've got an amazing catalog of songs, for sure. And here's the thing. You know, what we're doing tonight, people will be able to listen to this on the radio. We've got a video podcast out there as well. You can go to RealLifeRealMusic.com and find all that information. But my mom will be watching. They're getting up in age and not getting around as much as they used to, and so couldn't be here tonight. They're retired up in College Station. But she would really be angry with me if I didn't ask you to play her favorite song, which is True Love Ways. I wonder if you'd tell us about that one. Play that song.
Another
for
song
us.
That I missed too. Buddy Holly wrote the song, and I recorded it, and thanks for making it number one for me also. I'm waiting on them. Just you know why you and I will by and by no true love ways. Sometimes we'll sigh. Like we'll know why you and I know true love way throughout the days. Our true love ways will bring us joy to share with those care. Sometimes we'll sigh, sometimes we'll cry, but we'll know why you and I know true love ways. Written by Buddy Holly.
Yeah. So Mickey, that was another one back in the early 80s. And you know, one of the things about the 80s for you is you started branching out from just singing and started to work on your acting chops. Because, boy, you showed up on a whole lot of my favorite shows, Fantasy Island and... I mean, you were on a bunch of different TV programs doing cameos.
I did two Fall Guy segments. I did two Fantasy Islands. I did two Dukes of Hazzards.
Come on.
I did one Murder, She Wrote. And I had a scene in there where I grabbed Jimmy Dean by the collar and was shaking him. And one of the guys said, "What are you trying to do, shake the sausage out of him?" So that was kind of entertaining, and of course then I did the film, of course, Urban Cowboy with John Travolta.
Oh yeah, of course.
And we got
that was the first one. That's what broke the ice for me, I guess.
Okay, so tell us. Well, so you know, a lot of the people here are probably from the Houston area. I was in South Houston when you guys opened Gilley's, and obviously when that thing, that rocket ship just took off. What was that like when that happened, and how did it just change everything for you?
When the film The Urban Cowboy was released on the national scene, it opened up all the doors for Mickey Gilley and Johnny Lee. It launched us in the stratosphere at that time, 1980. All the showrooms in Vegas, Reno, Tahoe, and Atlantic City opened up, and we played up in Nevada quite a bit. I went to Europe, and we did some shows in Europe, and then we came back, and I got to play for two presidents at the White House, President Ronald Reagan, President George Bush Sr. And then the scary part happened. They invited me to come out to Hollywood, and they gave me a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame, which I was very honored to receive. But then the real scary part happened was when they asked me if I wanted to do some acting. But I did those acting roles, and I had a good time doing them too. And the first one I did was with the Lee Majors on The Fall Guy. And my first scene in the film, I was supposed to be nervous and scared. I wasn't acting, I was.
Yeah. Typecasting.
They had it just right. It was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun doing it.
Well, the whole time that you're doing all of that, you're still cranking out hits. I mean, the 80s is just filled with hits. Tell me about the song Talk to Me.
Well, I did Talk to Me, and I did Put Your Dreams Away and Lonely Nights. And we did all those tunes back in the 80s, which kept the ball out there in the court, you know, and everything kept rolling for us. And it was a very fun time for me because we were having number one songs.
Yeah.
And I had a producer one time tell me, he said, there's number one place on the charts, that's number one. If you're number two, that's second place. And so we kept striving to have number one songs.
Yeah.
And thanks to the folks that supported me in the country music scene, they gave me 17 number one songs. Now, I missed on a few of them, but I'd come back and have a number one song here and there, you know. But then, of course, you know, George Strait come along, and, you know, he topped everybody. Garth Brooks come along, he topped everybody, you know. But anyway, I had a good career, though, so I can't complain.
Can you give us a little taste of maybe some of those number ones?
Sure.
Lonely
you want
Nights,
me to do,
would
you like to do the medley of Talk to Me?
I got please.
Talk to Me, Lonely Nights, and Put Your Dreams Away.
Is that okay with you guys, everybody? Okay.
All right, Norm. Talk to me. Talk to me. Darling, I love the things you say. Talk to me. Talk to me. In your own sweet, gentle way. Let me hear. Tell me, dear. Tell me you love me so. Talk to me. Talk to me. Tell me what I want to know. Any way you speak of love, well, I've heard before. Honey, you know it sounds so good every time. Say the parts that I love just once more. Darling, I'm so glad you're mine. Talk to me. Talk to me. Hold me close and whisper low. Talk to me. Darling, can't you see? Baby, I love you so. Talk to me. Talk to me. Darling, I love you so. Yes, I do, honey. See if you remember this one. Heartbeat. I don't mean to waste your time. I just need someone to talk to, if you don't mind. Well, I fought the loneliness, but tonight I guess I'm just too weak to fight. And I can take the lonely days, I can't take these lonely nights. Well, I thought that I was strong, but the nights can't be so long when you need a friend. Maybe we can find a little peace of mind before the morning comes again. Pardon me if it seems I'm holding on, 'cause letting go just isn't easy when you're sleeping all alone. Think about that. Let's forget about tomorrow, thanks to the bottle. Just a little time, 'cause I can take the lonely days, but I can't take these lonely nights. I can take the lonely days, but I can't take these lonely nights. This next song is one of my favorite tunes I recorded. See if you remember this one. Every now and then, someone comes to you, and somehow you know a dream has just come true. Well, here it is, baby, and what I'm trying to say, here I am, darling, you can put your dreams away. Never wish for love, and you wish so long, you begin to think it would never come along. Well, here it is, baby, and what I'm trying to say, here I am, darling, you can put your dreams away. Put your dreams away and just lay beside me. Take all the love that's here inside me. Here's all the dream you'll ever need. Put your dreams away, rest them on my shoulders. Darling, the search is over. If you want to love, but you to stay, you can put your dreams. Thanks for making us number one for me.
Yeah. Have I told you thank you for being here tonight?
It's been an honor.
Wow,
pleasure.
Man. This has been amazing.
It's been a pleasure being with you folks.
You know, there's a song that I know that's special to you that you released back in 1980 that I wonder if you'd tell us about. It went number one for you. Called That's All That Matters to Me.
Yeah.
What if you tell us a little bit about that song and play that one for us?
Producer first brought it into the recording session. At the time, I listened to the song, and I told him I didn't think I had the voice to do it. And he says, this can be another good recording for you, Gilley. And he talked me into making a run at it. And sure enough, it turned out to be one of my favorite recordings that I made back in the 80s. It's called That's All That Matters, written by Hank Cochran. It's a beautiful song. And every now and then somebody will say, can you do it for our anniversary? And I said, that's not a good anniversary song because, you know, unless you've been married before. Because it starts off with, I'm not your first love, you know.
Yeah.
There's been others before me. But you want me to do that one for you?
Please do. All right.
One of my favorite tunes also. I know I'm not your first love. There's been others before me, but I'm the one who's got you now. That's all that matters to me. I know other arms have held you. I know you've been tender, pleased. Mine are the arms that hold you now. That's all that matters to me. I came alive when you came along. You brought life into me. Honey, I don't care what's in your past. You're as far as I can see. I know the return gets you. I know you've been thrilled and free. That man of the lips that kiss you now, that's all that matters to me. And on the lips that kiss you now, that's all that matters to me.
Yeah.
I always love the song, even though I missed the lyrics a little bit there on part of it because I was thinking about something else, but I'm not going to tell you what I was thinking about, though. I know I'm not your first love.
I'm not going to probe on that one there, Mickey. Okay, but I do want to know this. Whose brainchild was the first mechanical bull at Gilley's? Was that you or your partner? And who was y'all's insurance agent?
The insurance agent was very... That was not my idea to put the mechanical bull in Gilley's.
Because y'all were the
one. That was my business partner. When I went on the road with Conway Twitty back in 1974, I left the club, and I thought at the time I might be a one-hit wonder, so I wanted to hold on to what I had going in Houston. And my business partner wanted to try to keep people coming to the club. So he tried to attract all the people from the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo and the Pasadena Rodeo, and he installed this mechanical bull. And when I came in and saw the bull and what they were doing with it, I'm thinking, this is not going to work. And I told him so. And I said, we're going to get all kind of lawsuits. We did. But I was wrong because we got to film the Urban Cowboy on account of the mechanical bull.
That kind of made up for it.
They sure would cry that decided to do the mechanical bull. I thought it was a mistake, but it turned out.
But it worked. It worked. It was it another worked. One of those times that it worked out.
Right.
I know you had, obviously, both you and Johnny Lee, Urban Cowboy meant a lot to your careers. And I think you've got a little medley of songs that you do from the Urban Cowboy days. I wonder if you'd lay that on us tonight.
I can do the medley of songs, but you got time to do all the medley? I close with Stand By Me, of course. Okay, yeah, we can do it. That'll be the end of the show.
Or we can keep going, as far as I'm concerned.
Let's do the medley, all right? One little medley of the Urban Cowboy music for you. I was at the piano singing this song when John Travolta and his uncle first walked into the old nightclub, Gilley's. And you might remember the tune, it's called Sweet Honky Tonk Wine, and it went like this. honky tonk wine. Don't you know that it keeps me out of my mind? Oh, she left behind some of that sweet, sweet honky tonk wine. I was out drinking and laughing. A woman of mine was home packing. All she left was a bottle and a note, and I had a great time on some of that sweet, sweet honky tonk wine. Give me some sweet, sweet, sweet honky tonk wine. Don't you know that it keeps me, baby, out of my mind? All she left behind some of that sweet, sweet, sweet honky tonk wine. Some of that sweet honky tonk wine. Here comes the hurt again. You'd think I'd learn. The more I believe in love, the more I get burned. I'm lying right here again, so close to the flame. Here comes the hurt again, but I'm used to the pain. Here comes the hurt again, but I'm used to the pain. One of my favorite songs is by Boss Gags. Johnny Lee's Looking for Love. Here's Mr. Lee Hendricks on the keyboard.
Hope that never in this song this could take us all night long. I looked at the moon and I felt blue. Then I looked again and I saw you. Eyes like fire in the night. Bridges burning with their light. Now I want to spend the whole night through. And yes, I want to spend it all. What you've done to me, I never thought I'd fall again so easily. You wouldn't lie to me, giving me the feel this
Georgina. Gina.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, have you had a good time tonight? I want to say a special thank you to everybody here at Do-Si-Do for making wonderful music like this possible. I want to thank my friends at Chicago Title. We couldn't have done, you know, 265 shows without the support of our corporate sponsors. And I want to thank all of you guys for being here tonight. But most of all, Mickey, I want to tell you just how humbled I am to get to share the stage with you this evening and sit this close listening to music that I grew up listening to. Thank you for being here tonight.
It's been a pleasure and honor. Thank you for having me. It's been a wonderful experience, I don't mind telling you. I've enjoyed it.
Well, I know you've got a song that we all have to hear before we leave, and I tell you what, I don't know that there couldn't be a better time just in our country and in our communities to need a song like this right here to bring us all together. So I'm going to let you take it home for us tonight.
I think all of us can stand by me. When the night has come in the land, and the moon be the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. Stand by me. Won't you stand by me? If you're in need, won't you stand by me? If the sky we look upon should ever crumble and fall, and the mountains should fall to the sea, no, I won't be afraid. No, I won't shed a tear. Just as long as you stand by me. Guitar. Just like the record. I didn't stand by me. Won't you stand by me? If you're in need, won't you stand by me? One more time. Nothing stand by me. Won't you stand by me? If you're in need, won't you stand by me? Pleasure. Thank you all. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mickey Gilley. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for Mickey Gilley and Johnny Lee. Thank you for being here tonight. We'll see you next time.